In this video, we will start with the functions in JavaScript. So the module is called functions, and this will be the first exercise or video on functions called What Are Functions? When first learning how to calculate the area of a rectangle, there is a sequence of steps to calculate the correct answer. Measure the width of the rectangle, measure the height of the rectangle, multiply the width and height of the rectangle. With practice, you can calculate the area of the rectangle without being instructed with these three steps every time. We can calculate the area of one rectangle with the following code. Let's see. Const width equals 10, const height equals 6, const area equals width multiplied by height, and then we are logging the results. Imagine being asked to calculate the area of three different rectangles. So the same thing, just three times with different data. In programming, we often use code to perform a specific task multiple times. Instead of rewriting the same code, we can group a block of code together and associate it with one task. Then we can reuse that block of code whenever we need to perform the task again. We achieve this by creating a function. A function is a reusable block of code that groups together a sequence of statements to perform a specific task. In this lesson, you will learn how to create and use functions and how they can be used to create clearer and more concise code. Take a look at the provided GIF here on the right side of the page. It shows a function named addOneSide, adding an additional side to different shape inputs. Notice how there is only one function represented by the box that is used to transform individual shapes or inputs into new shapes and or outputs. And let's see the GIF. Function var, example 2. So here is the input. We have a function that does something with our input, and then here is the output. Now example 1. We started from example 2, so same thing. Input 1 to same function, and we got the output. So basically, we are using the same function, the same instructions in that function for different data. And now let's proceed to the next exercise and start writing some JavaScript functions.